Yes?
Is this where I report a death?
Who died?
Miss Amelia Townsend.
Up on the hill?
Yes, sir.
When?
This morning, at 9:10.
That was over 3 hours ago.
Oh, yes, sir. But it took me some time to get her dressed and fix her hair. She's outside in the car. She was a very mean woman. She wanted to destroy my garden. All she cared about was money.
Now, Mr. Walsh, in your official capacity with the United States Treasury Department, were you called upon to make an analysis of the ashes in the fireplace of the Townsend house?
I was.
What did you find?
The ashes were the result of burning United States currency, bills of large denominations.
How much money was burned?
I can't say, but it was considerable.
Could it have been as much as $1 million?
Yes, sir. Even more.
No, sir. I do not believe that anyone, even a madman, could bring himself to burn up more than $1 million.
Objection. What Mr. Manning believes or does not believe is irrelevant.
Mr. Manning was a confidant of the deceased and is executor of her estate. He has testified that she was old and eccentric, that she kept huge sums of cash in her home. And since the public defender just attempted to establish that this money was destroyed, the opinion of this witness is valid.
I'm a fellow of the American Psychiatric Society and the author of 2 textbooks now in use, Psychiatry in Relation to Crime and Modern Usages of Hypnoanalysis. At present, I'm assistant medical director of the State Psychopathic Hospital.
Thank you. Now, Dr. Bailey, are you acquainted with the philanthropic society known as the Townsend Foundation?
More than acquainted. As Mr. Manning knows, for the past several years, I've been trying to get a grant from them to expand my research. I'm still trying.
Dr. Bailey, were you present when Mr. Manning testified that he did not believe that even a madman could bring himself to burn up $1 million?
I was.
Do you agree with that opinion?
No, I don't. The amount of money certainly is unusual, but the act of destruction isn't. Martin Ashley is a lonely, secretive man, desperately in need of understanding friendship. This type of schizophrenic often is. He became convinced that Amelia Townsend was not his friend, but his enemy, that she intended using her wealth to destroy his garden and return him to our hospital where he had been a patient until 3 years ago. To his disordered mind, the decision was a simple one. Destroy the persecutor and her weapon, her money.
We find the defendant not guilty by reason of insanity.
Martin Ashley, under section 1500, it's mandatory for this court to commit you to the State Psychopathic Hospital for an indeterminate period of observation. Not less than 90 days. So ordered. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. You're dismissed.
Dr. Bailey, I hope you'll feel proud of yourself, Doctor.
What is that supposed to mean?
Why did you have to go out of your way to help that faker get away with murder and $1 million?
Mr. Cannon?
Yes, Doctor?
Mr. Manning, would you like to repeat your accusation in front of a witness?
Don't threaten me. I've been sued by experts.
Repeat it then. And I'll collect enough from you in court so I'll never have to apply for a grant again.
I will, in time, with concrete proof. I'm sick and tired of psychiatrists who try to play God, who tell us our mothers and fathers made us neurotic and psychotic.
Mr. Manning, I've gone through analysis as all psychiatrists do. Now I suggest you try it. The results might prove most interesting.
Lay on, Macduff. And damned be him that first cries, "Hold enough!"
You don't know me, Mr. Nelson.
Yes, I do. I held seats second row all week. If we had 100 customers like you, we wouldn't have to close this show tonight.
Well, I'm rather glad you did close. I have a proposition may interest you.
Listen, mister, you've been hanging around the wrong stage door.
What I have to say is strictly business. If you're interested in a high-salaried acting job, then let's not miss the train back to New York. I have a cab waiting. That's why I have to gamble that a fellow patient, you, Mr. Nelson, can get to Ashley and learn things the doctors couldn't. Maybe I'm just being bullheaded, but expensively so. Offering you $10,000 out of my own pocket for 30 days of acting.
One thing puzzles me. Me. Why did you pick me for this job?
The plus factors. You're a convincing actor. You have no close personal ties. And since you've never been in California, your masquerade shouldn't be uncovered.
Well, it almost sounds illegal.
It is. Oh, technically, we're conspiring for you to fraudulently enter the state psychopathic hospital and play the part of a mentally disturbed patient. Under the California Criminal Code, that's an indictable misdemeanor.
Prison.
County jail, 6 months maximum. And we both run the same risk. Think it over, Mr. Nelson. The greatest acting role of your career. And win or lose, $10,000. Another 10 if and when you find the money.
In relation to crime, phases of schizophrenia, what is insanity, modern usages of hypnoanalysis. Are you going to read all these?
No, I'm just going to look at the pictures. Floribunda rose, the type that bloom in clusters. And that's the, this group is called the hybrid polyanthus. What about the money, Mr. Manning?
Ready whenever you are. They're planting.
Well, never too deep, and don't cover the upper roots with more than 2 or 3 inches of topsoil. Well, how will you set it up?
A safe deposit box in your name only, but I keep the key.
Fair enough. Now, here we have the climbing roses. And that's the Bobkin White. This is Coral Dawn. And that's the Gladiator.
I think you're as rehearsed as a man could be.
Well, fine. Let's get the show on the road. You gentlemen conform,
Let's go, drunk.
Why not turn to these peasants, look them in the eye and say, to hell with conformity.
Dale Nelson, 73 Hillside, Hollywood.
Okay, now, what's your name?
Drunk?
No, sir. We ran them through every test, not even a whisper.
You gentlemen have my name, now yours, if you please.
$435 in his wallet.
Where'd you get this money, Nelson?
In transaction with a gas company and a manufacturer of pencils.
Stick up.
Is every man you propel through these doors necessarily a thief?
Never mind the speeches. I asked you about this money.
I assure you, I understand the question, and I intend answering it. At my height and weight, my body contains 4,500 cubic feet of nitrogen, hydrogen, oxygen, and 24 pounds of carbon. Now, the going rate for gas is 90 cents per 1,000 cubic feet. Now, that came slightly over $4.05. But I did a lot better with the carbon. 24 pounds of carbon will manufacture 1,000 dozen pencils. Now, that sale came to slightly over $200.
Are you sure you tested him?
Positive.
Disciples of conformity, huh? I bleed for the narrowness of your minds.
Call the sheriff's office. Tell him we have a customer for County Psycho. Lock him up till the wagon gets here.
This patient has been here for the prescribed time of 72 hours. In my opinion, his antisocial behavior indicates a disturbed state of mind. I recommend hospitalization for the customary period of observation.
I concur with my colleague.
I recommend hospitalization. I concur with my colleague. Now it becomes your turn to conform.
State hospital, 30 days.
I recommend, I concur, and I conform.
See, it's always been a case of jealousy. I had three doctors back in Ohio and two right here in California. Every single one of them. All five wanted me. Know what I mean, honey? You're stupid. And she's stupid.
Don't touch me. I don't like to be touched.
Talk about being crude. Crazy crude. My last doctor was really the one. When he got me in his office, he started telling me about the sex life of the primitives. You know, on the couch. Been that way all my life.
I came. You were alone. You should have known. I was. Da 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 da.
Not yet, Alice. Later. The show won't start for a couple of hours. You see, if you let these people see you now for free, well, they won't buy tickets later.
Oh? Sure. You said it. Thank you kindly.
Let's go, mister.
Sorry if I frightened you.
I wasn't frightened. I'm never frightened. I just dislike being touched.
Mr. Nunez?
Oh, come in, Mr. Ashley.
Nelson, you're next.
Dale Nelson, list of valuables.
You include the 54 ounces of phosphorus in my body?
Social Security card, driving license.
Commercial value, I mean.
One wallet with $435 in currency. You're permitted to carry $5 at a time on your person.
54 ounces of phosphorus will manufacture 60,000 matches.
Next.
The large size.
60,000 matches. You think it's true?
You know what I think? You're on the wrong side of this counter.
Doctors, you may speak in normal tones. The patient can't see or hear you.
Since you're just beginning your internships here, I wanted you to see various phases of our procedure. This is just a routine psychology test.
Now tell me what this picture means to you, Mr. Nelson.
Well, it's childishly obvious, isn't it? Those two worried conformists, one female, one male,
It's nighttime, and that's when the conformists worry the most, what the neighbors are thinking about them. Let's be honest with each other, Doctor. Let's tell the truth. Isn't that what you and your wife worry about?
I'm not married.
Apparently, this patient knows a conformist when he sees one.
All right. Please shut your eyes, Mr. Nelson.
Well, the last time I did this, I was expecting a bicycle. All I got was a yo-yo.
Close them. Up the way.
Tight.
Mm-hmm. Now, name the months of the year.
January, February, March, April, June, July, August, September, November, December.
About not getting that bicycle, did you blame your parents for that?
No, my uncle. He manufactured yo-yos.
You may open your eyes now.
Doctor, can you put me to work while I'm here? Something to keep me busy.
Definitely. Work is therapy.
Well, I'm a better than average amateur botanist.
We grow all our own vegetables here.
Well, that's agriculture, not horticulture. Don't you have a rose garden?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, we do.
Well, you're looking at the greenest thumb that was ever sent here for observation.
Well, I'm afraid we've got one patient here who will argue that point with you, Mr. Nelson.
Well, he'd lose. They've even made catalias bloom in near zero temperature.
Catalias?
Proof of evergreen orchids, Doctor.
Oh, you must be the green thumb the doctor just mentioned.
Hardly. This is Dr. Bailey.
Oh, Doctor.
How do you do?
We've been through the Rorschach and the TAT.
Mm-hmm. Suppose I continue with the patient.
Fine. I'll check the ward.
Excuse me. You sit over there. Patient's choice of therapy, gardening. Mr. Nelson, are you left-handed?
Of course not.
When we shook hands, you used your left hand.
I did.
Don't you remember?
No, ma'am.
Is horticulture your hobby?
Yes, ma'am.
And roses your specialty?
Well, I enjoy working with them. Floribunda and hybrids are doing particularly well this year.
I see. Mr. Nelson, will you please name the months of the year?
Well, I already did.
Yes. Again, if you don't mind.
January, February, March, April, May, July, August, September, November, December.
How many months in the year?
12.
You omitted June and October.
I did. Are you sure?
Before, according to this report, you omitted May and October.
Are you trying to convince me that I do belong here?
Mr. Nelson, the patient convinces the doctor, not vice versa. Destruction of private property, disturbing the peace, and several counts of disorderly conduct. Have there been similar disturbances prior to the one in Beverly Hills?
Well, Doctor, I prefer calling them expressions of personal opinion.
Mr. Nelson, the court order gives us 30 days to make our recommendation. In other words, to diagnose the state of your mental health.
To express another personal opinion, Doctor, I assure you I'm just as sound as a dollar used to be.
Well, that diagnosis wouldn't surprise me at all. Mr. Nelson, I've been practicing psychiatry long enough to always expect the unexpected. You may return to your ward now.
What about the gardening job, Doctor?
Oh, you can report to the records office at 8 tomorrow morning. Your work detail card will be waiting for you.
Thank you.
There have been a few calls, nothing important.
Send in a request to the Los Angeles Sheriff's Office. I want a more detailed report on one of our court hold patients. Dale Nelson, Ward C. Have them check his fingerprints with Washington. Any and all information you can find.
Some dashes. Morse code. You read it?
No.
Now. Shh. Now. Not tonight. Trouble developed. Must postpone bombing. Will contact very soon.
Roger. And out.
We're safe tonight. I'll let you know. Good night.
Don't let him bother you, Nelson. Poor fellow's harmless. I'm afraid we took him off his sedation too soon. He was doing fine on triflupromazine.
Do you work the night shift?
With Al Simon. We take turns catching sleep when things are quiet. You better get some sleep.
Well, I wish I could, but...
No problem. Go out to the day room and ask Al for a pill. A number 4.
Oh, well, thanks, sir.
Go ahead, I'll wait.
Saw my girl. What is it?
Well, I can't seem to sleep tonight. I wonder if you give me a pill. Number 4.
Sure thing. How come you know about a number 4?
Well, your partner told me about it.
Oh, Capshaw. You see, you're,
Nelson. Dale Nelson.
There's water next to the television set. Incidentally, Nelson, Capshaw was a technician here for years. He's one of the best, but he's been a patient now for some time. You better hit that sack. Those number 4s rock you real fast.
This is your work detail card. Just clip it to the pocket of your shirt, and they'll let you through the main yard gate to the free area. Your who?
Said I should come down here and then I could go to the pottery shed.
Well, you must be Frank Josephson.
I said I could work in pottery.
Right away.
They said I could work in pottery. That's what they told me.
Well, sure. She's fixing up your card right now.
Busy. You're who?
Adele Nelson, Ward C, the Rose Garden detail.
These are for the files, miss. But take your time. We won't allow patients to understand there's no need to hurry. Morning, old timer.
Morning, young fella.
We taking care of you?
Oh, no complaints.
Going to the dance Saturday?
Why not?
Fine therapy. You going, miss?
No.
Wrong attitude, miss. There's rhyme and reason for everything we program here. You see, now you think that you've got great big problems, but you go to the dance and you'll meet people with bigger problems. Makes you realize that you're a lot healthier than most folks.
Oh, Mr. Capshaw, can you take this patient to the pottery detail?
Can and will. Therapy, miss, therapy. You go along with us and we'll be sending you back real quick. Let's go, old-timer. Pottery, next stop.
This is your work detail card.
Thank you. Just clip it to the pocket of my shirt and they'll let me through to the main yard gate into the free area.
Hey, young fella. Wait for me. How about that girl in the office? Well, what's her problem?
Sorry, every diagnosis we make is confidential.
They said I could work in pottery.
Okay. All right.
Hey, don't touch that plant.
Why not? I've been assigned here. Oh, my name's Nelson. Dale Nelson. What's yours? Okay, mister, if that's the way you want it.
Handle that gently.
Don't teach me my business. I don't take advice from amateurs.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Morning, Doctor.
Oh, Doctor, thanks for the job.
I happen to be in charge of this garden. So, don't you call me an amateur.
Okay, mister. I won't call you an amateur if you don't call this nothing a garden.
I'm sure you'll all be interested in this use of hypnosis. Hypnotic probing into the subconscious can still take months, even years of relationship between patient and doctor.
And once, it was a Saturday, she said she had to go downtown to see her cousin.
Tell me, who is she?
My mother.
What happened that Saturday, Cynthia? What happened, Cynthia?
She used to make me write things. Hundreds of times. Over and over. Over and over!
What things? Tell me, Cynthia.
No.
Yes, tell me.
No. No, no. No, it wasn't true. I wrote it, but... wasn't true.
What wasn't true, Cynthia?
No.
Yes, tell me.
No, no, no.
What wasn't true?
No, 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 no.
Yes, Cynthia.
No, 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 no.
These physical reactions occur when the subconscious rebels, fights against revealing unpleasant memories or guilty secrets.
No, 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 no.
All right, Cynthia. Never mind that now. No more questions. No more. Sleep, Cynthia. Sleep. I'm going to place my hand on your forehead. When you wake, you will not remember what we talked about. Do you understand, Cynthia?
Yes, I understand.
Wake up.
Anyone care to offer a quick diagnosis?
Manic depressive?
Definitely. In the depressed phase of the cycle.
Stop now! No more shock treatment! Please! Please! No more shock! No more shock! Stop them! Stop them! No more shock! No more shock! Stop them! Stop them! Stop!
Capshaw?
Every Thursday,
Don't do that.
In here, please. This is my personal menagerie. It's too small, but all that I can afford. The state doesn't give us any funds for research. And private sources, getting money from them is next to impossible. My two simian friends here cost me a full month's pay. Fortunately, white rats and mice are cheaper. Hello, Sam. It's easy to find rats for dangerous experiments. But how many human beings can you find who are willing to let you experiment with their minds? You see, when the organic researcher looks for a cure for some body-killing disease, he tries to reproduce it by getting a patient to volunteer to submit to the experiment. But a mental patient can't volunteer. And if you even try to get his consent, goodbye, license and career. You close the door, please. You sit down. The rest of you can stand. Now, I'm now going to show you some definite results of my research into the chemistry of the mind. Solve that, doctors. Completely solve it. And drugs will control mental illness as easily as they control diabetes. Would you turn out the lights, please? Now, this isn't a travelogue. Only the location of the first field station where I was permitted to work. Of homicidal impulses. The problem was to affect and then control the chemistry of his mind by causing a state of catatonia. I found the jugular vein easier to use.
Triflupromazine, doctor?
Oh, no, I've gone far beyond triflupromazine, far beyond LSD, or anything else in use today. As you can see, reaction began in less than a minute. Doctors, you will never see a more complete state of catatonia.
How long did the catatonia last, Doctor?
Well, the first time, it lasted about 36 hours. After the third injection, it became permanent. Unfortunately, an animal cannot describe the thoughts and hallucinations that pass through his mind. Lights, please.
How would your drug affect a human being?
Well, that's something we'll never know, Doctor. Unless, of course, in the name of science or mankind, one of you would like to volunteer. Not an idealist or tiger in the room.
Hey, head gardener, where do you keep the peat moss? I said, where do you keep the peat moss? Hey, listen, mister, I asked you a simple question.
There isn't any.
There isn't any? Well, this whole section needs mulching.
They promised delivery over 2 weeks ago.
Promised? Well, you can't feed roses on promises. What kind of a head gardener are you?
Don't talk to me like that. Now, I'm warning you, don't. All you do is find fault and complain since you first started here.
Well, I can't stand around and watch a garden die.
And you think I enjoy it, huh? Well, I care about that much more than you do.
The hell you do. Listen, I've been surrounded by roses ever since I could crawl.
That does not make you an authority, just fortunate. I didn't see a flower until I was 16. You don't get flowers at the orphanage, mister.
Well, then how were you elected head gardener?
Because ever since that time, I have nursed and raised every variety of rose there is. I've even crossbred them.
Oh! Who cares what you think? I am the guy who crossbred the Pinocchio with the Fusilier, and it won the first prize at the Pasadena show in 1962. Don't hand me that. Listen, I was at that show, and there wasn't anybody by the name of Ashley even mentioned.
I didn't say I won. Did I say I won? I didn't say I won. I said my crossbreed won. Yeah, you think they give first prize to nobody? Yeah, not in a million years. Oh, the blue ribbon went to the old woman I worked for. Miss Amelia Townsend.
That Floribunda rose masquerade? That orange scarlet against red? Are you telling me that was your rose? Was that your rose?
Oh, yeah. Every petal. After 2 years of experimenting.
Oh, brother, how stupid can I get? Calling you an amateur. Telling you not to teach me my business. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, listen, Mr. Ashley, I'd like to apologize. I'm more sorry about that than I am about anything. Really, I am.
Well, thank you. And no harm done.
Pals?
He sketched the house and garden I used to work in.
I see. Well, apparently putting you two together was a very happy arrangement.
Why is putting two people together necessarily a happy arrangement? Is she your doctor?
Yes.
What kind of treatments are you getting?
Analysis. Hey, Dale. You ever think of having a garden of your own?
Oh, that's my favorite dream. What do you do in analysis?
A lot of talking.
You mean you just sit around and talk?
Mm-hmm.
About what?
Oh, I don't know. I can't remember what we talk about. Look, see, I'd have rose hedges on three sides like this, surrounding a rose bed 100 feet long.
And an arbor of climbing roses over here. You know, it's lucky that we don't get charged for dreaming.
Well, maybe your dream will come true one day.
No. I always wake up just before it does.
Maybe you'll meet somebody. A friend who will want you to help create a garden. Just like you've always dreamed about.
Oh, cut it out, will you, Martin?
Well, suppose you did. I mean, meet somebody.
Oh, quit supposing, will you? You're beginning to sound like some of these guys around here.
What makes you think I'm not serious?
Well, if you are, you're crazy.
Oh, don't say that. Don't you ever say that to me again.
Martin, Winston, Martin!
Oh, don't be that way. You're right, Arthur. He's crazy. Come on, Arthur. We'll make some vitamins.
I'm not Arthur.
No, I know it. But they don't know it. You take 2 pints water and watch. Yeah? Yeah. 1 pint ketchup. Vitamins D and E for iron.
Vitamins.
So, you try it. 2 pints water.
Why aren't you dancing?
Oh, hi. Well, I'm looking for Martin Ashley.
Oh, this is not his kind of therapy at all. He doesn't like the way we use his flowers to decorate the halls. Well, gotta keep circulating, old-timer.
Hello, Miss Albright. Would you like to dance?
No. I'd rather not.
Sorry.
See the way he looked at me? All he wanted to do was take me in his arms. You know what I mean, honey? You're stupid. You're stupid jealous.
Would you mind some company? May I? It's pretty here. Why do you prefer being so alone?
I'm embarrassed being here. Being one of them. And I am, you know.
Well, 6,000 of us are. The patients leave here every day.
I'm not so sure I want to. It isn't so bad. Being in the shadows, listening to the music. You know, when you're in the shadows, away from people, the music just kind of floats in the air. It's so pretty and nice.
Like your name. Cynthia Lee Albright.
My mother's creation. Names must be mellifluous, Cynthia. People who want to be important must have mellifluous names. So here I am. Cynthia Lee Albright. Ward M of the State Nut House. I'm sorry, I shouldn't use that expression.
I don't mind. Where are you from?
Wichita. My father died there. 2 years ago, last Monday. I left the next day.
Is your mother still there?
I wouldn't know. My father always tried to talk up for me. Even when she said bad things about me. He used to bring me presents. And then she'd found them and she took them away. My mother used to make me write things. Hundreds of times. I swear I will never again walk home from school with a boy. Today I was not a respectable girl. Kissing and touching are sins. And my mother loves me best of all.
I'm sorry, sir.
Don't touch me. I told you not to touch me.
You still saw at me? I'm sorry I sounded off the way I did, Martin. I had no right doing that. If it wasn't for you, meeting somebody who talked my language, had the same interests, I'd have ducked out of here days ago. You know, making friends isn't easy for me.
Well, truthfully, the only reason I came here tonight was to look for you and explain. Dale, I wasn't just supposing the other day. I mean about the friend who might come along. It's just that... Well, I can't tell you any more right now.
Well, okay, Martin. As long as we're still friends. Come on, let's have some coffee, huh? In case you happen to run into that friend of yours, would you tell him that Dale Nelson said, have dream and suitcase will travel?
He might want to go as far as Australia.
Well, that suits me. Anywhere roses grow. I'll be out 90 days.
That soon.
My observation time will be up.
Where will you be? In Los Angeles?
Well, for a day or two. Can't stand to have people pointing at me saying I just got out of a state hospital. I guess I'll go east.
Where?
Well, wherever I can work with roses.
Oh, excuse me. There's someone I've got to see.
I think this is Joan.
Doctor, can I talk to you for a moment, please?
Yes, of course. What is it?
Doctor, can you tell me how soon I'll be discharged from here?
Well, I can tell the court that you're well.
Oh, but I am well. I've been here way over 90 days. Well, Doctor, it's very important that I leave here in 19 days at the latest.
Why?
Well, I can't tell you that. It's very private.
Well, I suppose we discuss it in my office, hmm?
Yeah, thank you, Doctor, thank you.
There must be a reason. Tell me, Martin, why must you leave here in 19 days?
Because Dale is leaving and I have to go with him.
Where will you go?
Oh, far away. Australia.
What will you do there?
Create the most beautiful garden in the whole world. So many roses. We'll have a great, big, beautiful house.
Well, that will cost a great deal of money, won't it? Mm-hmm. Tell me, Martin, That will cost a great deal of money, won't it?
Yes.
Do you have enough money for all that? Do you have enough money for all that? You know you can't leave here until I tell the court that you're cured.
I am cured. I am cured. I am cured!
Sleep, Ma. Sleep. Now, open your eyes and tell me, Martin. Do you have enough money for all that? Do you, Martin? Do you have enough money, Martin?
Yes!
Tell me, Martin. How much money do you have?
No.
You want me to let you leave here when Dale leaves, don't you?
Oh, yes, yes. Please.
All right, Martin. I can't help you if you don't trust me. You must trust me. Tell me, Martin.
Hmm?
How much money, Martin?
$1 million.
Tell me where the money is.
No.
You must trust me, Martin. You must trust me. Tell me where the money is.
No!
Take it easy, Martin. Don't worry. Just relax. Sleep, Martin. No more questions. When I place my hand on your forehead, you will wake. But you will remember nothing that we have talked about. Not a single word or thought. Wake up, Martin. I'll see you again in a few days, Mr. Ashley.
Doctor, will I be able to leave here soon?
It's very likely. I'll do everything I can to help you arrange it after a few more treatments.
Oh, thank you, Doctor. Thank you very much.
Hello?
Collect call for Mr. Hospital.
Yes, I'll accept the charges. Well, I'm relieved to hear from you, Mr. Hospital.
I've got some great news for you. That fellow really has that money. Unfortunately, we're going to have some competition.
That lady who was at the trial?
Dr. Bailey? She knows as much or more about things than I do. Of
course, I should have suspected that. When she testified for him, she must have known he'd never destroyed that money.
It will give me great pleasure to call in the authorities.
No, no, not yet. If they get into this act now, we'll never find out where the money is. And remember, I'm a man who's interested in that bonus.
I'm delighted with your progress.
Oh, somebody's coming. Somebody's coming. Bye.
What are you doing in here?
Well, I'm looking for my sneakers.
Why do you need sneakers?
Well, because everyone dances in shoes, and I prefer sneakers.
Never mind. You'll have to dance as you are.
Conformity. Conformity. Everywhere I go, in every city, conformity.
I changed my mind. I'd like to dance.
Well, how? No hands?
Well, that wouldn't be much fun, would it, Mr. Nelson?
Why don't you make it Dale? It's more mellifluous.
Mm-hmm.
psychiatrists, psychologists, neurologists, all over the place. All in search of a problem.
Have you got one?
So they tell me. One turn around the greenery and I just may tell you about it. Kind of floats in the air. Listen, it really does float. Nice?
Therapeutic.
Cynthia Lee Albright aims to please. Well, doctor, do you want to know my problem?
Do you want to tell it to me?
How can you make your diagnosis if I don't? Come on, doctor. 60 pulsations to the minute. 70 here. Do you think I'm attractive?
I don't think that's your problem.
No. That's just to let you know I'm a liar. Doctor, when Cynthia Lee Albright says that she doesn't want you to touch her, she's a liar. I want you to touch me, Dale. I want you to hold me and touch me. Now. 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 She said no one would ever want me. No one would ever love me. But she was wrong. Wrong. Love me, Dale. Love me. Love me. Tell me she was wrong.
She was wrong. Tell me. She was very wrong.
Tell me. Show me. Show me.
Not this way, Cynthia. Not in a place like this.
Liar! At least be as honest as she was.
Cynthia, listen to me. Liar. Please listen.
Liar! Liar!
It's not me.
Liar!
Yours?
No, no, it can't be. You've got to have the wrong number.
You're on tonight's list. They probably want you to take a test or two tomorrow.
What kind of tests?
Not my department. Down the hatch, friend.
Well, as soon as I finish my cigarette.
Uh-uh, no dice, Nelson. My job is to watch it go down. Or deliver it out of the end of a hypodermic. Take your choice.
Oh, well, you leave me no choice. Happy days.
Hi. Yeah, what is it? So, where are you taking me?
Therapy.
Therapy? I don't need therapy. This is a shop room. Oh, let me out of here. Let me go! What the hell is this, though? What the hell is this? Remove the restraints. Start at 90 volts. Insufficient. Increase it to 100.
Thank you.
Mr. Nelson, can you hear me? Can you hear me? Now look at me and listen. Days ago, I watched you use your left hand to shake hands, your fingertips to shut your eyes, the rehearsed moves of a faker. Mr. Nelson, I know you are a professional actor. But what I insist on knowing is why you chose to act your way into this particular hospital.
You say you know I'm a faker. And you put me through electroshock.
Mr. Nelson, I detest stupid people who think they can fake mental illness, who take up the precious time we need for legitimate patients. I want to know why you came here.
Well, you can go to hell.
Do you know the penalty for fraudulently entering a state hospital?
Not nearly as tough as a penalty for torturing a sane man. When I get through telling the courts about this, it'll be a pleasure for me to serve my 6 months in jail, knowing that they've booted you out of the medical profession into prison.
You've made your point, Mr. Nelson. Under other circumstances, Mr. Nelson, I would be happy to try to analyze your kind of twisted thinking. What makes you believe, Mr. Nelson, that a liar and a thief has the right to threaten my professional life? My research can't afford you, but paradoxically, most certainly can use you. We've had this patient under observation for almost 3 weeks. Our findings are that he is a catatonic schizophrenic with only periodic phases of mobility. But potentially he's dangerous to himself and to society. I therefore respectfully petition this court to terminate the present observation order and commit this patient for an indeterminate period.
We concur with Dr. Billy. Very well, so ordered.
Dale?
Is he a friend of yours?
My God. What happened to him?
He's catatonic. Something snaps inside and they just go off.
I can't believe it. I just can't.
Well, visiting him might help. We're out here every day. Now, this one used to come out of it every couple of months while his wife was alive, making visits. Hasn't moved a muscle now in almost a year. You know, in a way, they're better off than we are. But there's no sense, there's no feel. Easy, Nelson. Easy now. Here you are. This will help.
What's that?
It's only water.
No. Who are you?
Mike Newton. I've been taking care of you the past few days.
Few days?
Forget it. You're okay now.
Oh, no, I'm not okay. Strange kind of things floating around inside my head. It's colors. It's purple and green and blue. All floating into each other. Horrible, twisted images I've never seen before. And there was nothing.
You can go get your dinner now, Mike. I won't need you.
Yes, ma'am.
No. Don't go. Mike, don't go, please.
Is there anything further you can recall about those images, Mr. Nelson?
No.
Try to remember. Whatever you can.
No, I can't remember anything, Nelson. What are you doing? Please, Doctor, let me go.
There's no reason to panic, Mr. Nelson. The second phase will last only a few days longer.
No, you're insane.
Try to describe your sensations. Watch my face now. Is my face changing? Receding? Getting smaller?
Time for your airing, pal. Hi. Here's your boy.
Any change?
Too soon, I guess. Well, while you visit, I'll shop talk.
Don't talk, he'll hear. If he comes any closer, touch your face and I'll know. I'm all right now. But I don't know how long I can keep him believing I'm catatonic. Cynthia, I'm scared. I've never been so scared in all my life. You've got to help me. There's no place else I can turn. You're my last hope. The keyboard in the office. The key to the isolation ward in the building. Bring it to me tonight at the dance.
Too bad you're away, Nelson. Your friend's a real yum-yum.
Well, Mr. Ashby, he looks better tonight.
Being out here in the garden might help.
Fine, fine. Best therapy there is. Good evening, Your Highness.
Why did you lie to me? Why did you make me believe you were my friend? Dr. Bailey told me why you came here. She's my friend. You're never going to leave here now. But I am. I'm going home tonight. I'm glad I'll never have to see you again. I don't need you anymore. I'm cured now. I'll never need anybody. Ever again. After tonight, when I give Dr. Bailey the money she needs, I'm going far away. Far away from people like you. I've never had a real friend. Never. You didn't care about the roses. You didn't care about going away with me. All you cared about was money. Like Miss Townsend. Oh, yeah, that's why she wasn't fit to live. Neither are you.
Hey, you. What the hell are you doing with my patient?
We used to work together in the Rose Garden.
How dare you move him without permission?
Dale, my poor Derby. If you could only talk to me.
Just you stay away from him from now on.
up, you go for it.
Security office, quick.
Sorry about the hour. Well, I'm Dale Nelson, a friend of Mr. Manning.
Please come in, sir.
Thank you.
This way, Mr. Nelson.
Mr. Manning?
Yeah. Terrible loss, isn't it, sir?
Well, what happened to him?
A sudden heart attack yesterday morning. You're welcome to go in, sir.
Oh, I'd rather not. Did Mr. Manning have a close business associate, somebody I can get to tonight?
Yes, sir. His secretary, Miss Lindsay. She's inside.
Would you ask her to step out here? It's very important.
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Miss Lindsay? I'm Dale Nelson.
Well, what is it?
Well, doesn't my name mean anything to you?
Not a thing.
Well, I've been working for Mr. Manning on a personal matter. You'll find the details in his file.
Hardly. I do all the filing.
Well, it might be listed under the name of Mr. Hospital.
I assure you, there's nothing.
Well, it wouldn't be in the usual files. It was very confidential.
Well, that's absurd.
Well, all I'm asking you to do is to look.
Please, don't raise your voice. It's hardly proper.
I'm sorry, Miss Lindsay. I wouldn't bother you at a time like this, but I can't wait. I'm in serious trouble. Mr. Manning couldn't afford to let anyone know why he hired me. He even agreed to pay me $10,000 out of his own pocket.
$10,000?
Yes, you see, we're breaking the law. Now, I'm sure you'll find some kind of memorandum about it and the safe deposit key, too.
Very well. I'll look.
Well, thank you.
Oh, I'm sorry, but our records are personal. You'll have to wait. This is Miss Lindsay, 608 North Sierra. I want to report a case of attempted blackmail and extortion. A man who calls himself Dale Nelson is here trying to involve Mr. Manning in a crime.
Send two cars to 608 North Sierra. Now listen to me, madam, and don't lose your head. He's the man who just escaped from the state hospital.
An escaped lunatic? Oh, I was just checking. I mean, consulting. You know, oh, don't touch me. I'll scream.
I'm not going to hurt you, Miss Lindsay. I just want you to know what you've done. I'm in trouble because Mr. Manning hired me to find Amelia Townsend's money. And you've just taken away the only chance I had.
Here now. You count out your share.
But it's ashes. Oh, ashes.
Bill, what are you doing?
It can't be.
Bill, that's all.
Hey, you stop that!
Martin, did you lie to me?
What?
You said there was money. You told me that you hid it. Now, where is the money?
I am going to keep my word. Now, I'm going to count out your share, but that's all you get.
Martin, I want to talk to you. Now, give me that thing. Now, come on, give it to me.
You want my money too, don't you? You're just like her. Yeah, you both want my money, don't you?
Said the money was here. Oh. It is here. It really is, isn't it? I spent 31 hours with this patient. 31 separate hours. He had to be telling me the truth.
There isn't anything. There never was. Come on, let's go.
Yes, yes, of course. We'll start looking. Where? There, the house. What, out here? Will you help me, please?
Yes, of course. But we'll need some more help. I'll show them this, then. Then we'll come back. Yes, Doctor?
You're very kind.
Your Honor, this was a dedicated woman. The scientist of great vision, but deluded vision. Her ultimate collapse came with the realization that her purpose in life, her cause and career, had ended.
Because the money didn't exist?
Yes, sir.
No, sir! No, sir! No, sir! Positively no, sir! The money does exist. And who's in a better position to know after 31 hours? Well, tell me that. Who can challenge it? This is the time. Now. The present.
Let us examine every phase of this case. Agreed?
All right. 31 separate hours.
Do I have the right to be certain? Agreed?
All right.
We begin with a lonely, secretive type of schizophrenic. We know how difficult he is to reach. Agreed? All right. And who is in a better position to know? Tell me that. Now, for the other side of the case.
If a combination of chemical components will induce a state of catatonia, then inversely, a combination of chemical opposites will dissipate it. Agreed?
You're stupid. And she's stupid.
31 separate hours. I had every right to be certain.